Hello everybody and welcome back to episode 2 of Truly React. So if you're popping in for the second episode but not the first, the thing in the bottom right corner is connected to this app, is detecting this apparatus, which is connecting and reading my brainwaves. So first we did the first 2 chapters, I believe, and now it looks like we are heading, as the title says, trip to the circus. So this is in Guild Wars 2. This is the new but week old living world content in the Ring of Fire, which, if for anybody that's played Guild Wars 1, well, pure nostalgia. And finally it's daylight and look at, yeah, beautiful. So I have to go really west. Okay. Oh, looks like I could just take a... That's the wrong one.
This looks like a fine place.
That wasn't the exact idea I had. Try that again, because we royally effed that up.
Dragon research. We're lucky she enlisted our help.
Oh, sure, she'll be famous, but it won't do us any good if we die out
here. To the west.
It's my destiny. Better
is that the village?
All the way out here? The circus on the Fire Islands. This definitely merits investigation.
Customer, a real customer. Hold on just a minute. I'm not prepared. Welcome to Ember Bay's one and only circus, where you'll witness the grandest marvels Tyria has to offer. Want to buy a ticket?
No time right now. I'm looking for an ancient device, dwarven in make. There's supposed to be one nearby. Do you know it?
Searching for antiquity, eh? We've got a piece that may interest you. Not sure it's dwarven, but it sure is old. I might be convinced to let you in free of charge if you give me a hand with my chores. Otherwise, ticket holders only.
Here's my ticket. If you don't grant me access to that machine, the Fire Islands will erupt, taking your circus with it.
Oh, I guess we can overlook protocol for today. Go on in. Behold one of Ember Bay's greatest mysteries.
Oh boy. Kind of weird. And with no, map.
Only 2 more machines to find. Next on the list, the caldera.
So last episode we activated one of these devices with a dwarven stone thumb. Decided to stop there because it was going pretty long. Looks like this episode we're going to get the rest of them. For the caldera. Okay, it's going to be interesting to figure out how to get there. Crazy looking.
Hmm.
Out of the wrong one. Hit that. I could hit that. Hit the. Get a vista. Let's see what the thermal tube has in store for us. Wonder if you can. Please tell me you can Mario Kart that dirt. Oh, you can. Oh boy. A lava worm. Ooh. How do I get up? Probably gonna give me the stuff to collect dwarven artifacts. Holy moly. Mushatron. Hit it, thank you. They have gotten more elaborate with these. I could not imagine doing this without ley line gliding. Get out of there.
Excellent. An assistant arrives. I must remember to thank Timmy once we're out of here. Now to business. What do you suppose this contraption is?
It's an ancient dwarven device, one of four. If we don't fix it and activate it, this island is going to erupt.
Well, you're surprisingly well informed for an assistant. Okay then. This machine was shattered by a volcanic bomb expelled from the caldera. Parts scattered everywhere. I can fix it if I get the missing parts, and then power it by harvesting latent magical energy from the caldera. I'd certainly appreciate assistance gathering parts and keeping the local wildlife at bay, if you're willing and able.
Okay, I'll get it done.
Of course. I'm machine part. Oop.
Hmm.
Come on, that's no Norn over there. Not staying and fighting. Turn to the scientist. Alright, come on. Keep it moving. What's up, Smusher Troll? Here we go, up, up, and up some more. Get around. Come on.
You've proven more useful than I expected. Thank you.
There's still one more machine I must activate. Do you know where I can find it?
We detected the signature of another one of these devices in the Mursaat Fortress, west of here near the coast. We'd have investigated it already, but none of us have dared set foot in that perilous place. Do be careful, Commander.
Now it's time to move on.
Okay. Go full on west. Let me get back to that. I think I gotta ride that. Alright. Well, it's gonna be fun to go to a Mursaat Fortress. And yes, I am playing this straight through, even though these are separate episodes. I do have a clip on my ear. That thing is starting to hurt. Just get a cool scenic view. Eliminate nooks and cream. Crit stash. Oh. Calcum, where you at? Oh, up top. Up top. I'm coming.
I'm too smart to keep down.
Out of nowhere. As the dragons return to their slumber, the elder races reemerge. Oh no, Lore! The once powerful Jotun refused to rely on magic ever again. Since remained ignorant, brutish creatures. Cool. Let me out.
Hoy there, friend. Watch your step up ahead. The fortress is fit with defenses that will tear you to shreds.
Is that what happened to you?
Me? No, not exactly. My name's Grumby. Used to work for the White Mantle as a ferry captain here. And then they started sacrificing people for that bloodstone. And it wasn't long before I found myself on an altar. I stuck around to warn any wayward travelers about the dangers up ahead. So, consider yourself warned.
The warning's appreciated, but I have to get inside that fortress. There's a machine inside I need to activate. If I fail, these islands will be destroyed. How can I get past the defenses?
Defenses only allow Mursaat to enter. Anybody who doesn't look the part is cut down where they stand.
Could I disguise myself as a Mursaat to fool the defenses?
What? That'll never work. Wait, could that work? That might actually work. There's some Mursaat armor nearby. It's very well defended. But if you can get it, it'll make a serviceable disguise.
Only one way to find out.
Worst case scenario, the Scourge of the Mursaat claims another innocent. But at least I'll have some company.
Hmm. Interesting ghost. I'd like to help you, but you really made it difficult.
I need energy.
Missed it.
I know you.
Cut around the huh? Elder races could not agree on what to do. Jotun hid from the dragons. The dwarves withdrew into their fortresses. The seer stored magic for use after the dragons returned to sleep. Ooh. Probably should get that one on the north. Rocky. Oh no. Good touch. No, 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 no. Stop it. Good touch on the ether towers. I was going north. Oh. Scenic. With music. Crying hot lava, but you know, it's crying. Please don't somehow be on the top of this. I don't think that's possible. Nope, down arrow, sweet. Dun, 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 dun. Free falling. I'm gonna look like a Mursaat. I Now this place is more peppered with friggin' jade armors. Oh boy. Running down. Mind me. But don't mind me. Run. Fudge. Text on that. Hey. Floor tablet. You're dying for lore. Hopefully.
I'm shielded.
Ow. Let me cast my stuff on you.
Behold, dragon and hero together.
Close to
the pains of this world are fleeting.
Allow me to act. All right, we Mursaat and the Forgotten forged armies of powerful constructs to destroy the dragons. Seers, the dwarves, and Jotun did not want to fight. It drove a rift between us and them. Huh. Gonna suck. No. I'm sorry. A lot of things there. Nope. No! You poo-poo heads. What's the other one? What this one goes.
It has been too long. Allow me to act.
That's don't worry about me.
Grace is mine.
The pains of this world are fleeting.
Holy crap, I'm getting locked down. Sideways into another layer of awareness to avoid having sideways another layer of awareness. Yeah, well, I got your token. Centuries passed, the Yellow Dragons consumed all of Tyria's magic. Once prosperous cities lay in ruins, civilizations fell into an age of darkness, brutality in the absence of oh, I looked at the Mursaat thing now. Okay. Clear it, clear it. Yeah, that's why they didn't. Yeah, that's probably why they didn't attack me.
Well, I'll be. You sure look the part. Those defenses shouldn't trouble you now. Good luck in your search. If you fail and the volcano erupts, at least it'll take this terrible place with it.
Now I ascend. You're walking like I own the place. Going to the tippy tippy top to that door. I never saw him or saw it jump this much though. A lore tablet, yes please. We assaulted Zaitan with our army of jade constructs and enchanted armors. We failed, and many Mursaat and Forgotten died. We never forgive the other elder races for deserting us. Now, like we, as in the collective Mursaat, or we, as in the Mursaat and the Forgotten? We saved the day.
Oh. I should return to Robot. Refreshing.
I think Heavy was dragged into the guessing that could be very dwarven. Okay, Roban.
The Isles are downright peaceful. Guess you found all of the contraptions, huh? Of course, it won't be long until the torrent builds again. Perhaps by then I'll have these scrit whipped into shape. Hey, you still with me, friend? You've got this faraway look in your eyes. Where'd you float off to just now? You all right?
I just had a vision. A pretty ominous one.
A vision? You sure it's not just the heat playing tricks on you?
This was no hallucination. I have to get back to Tahrir as soon as possible.
Guess I'll have to take your word for it. Well, thank you for the help, friend. The Fire Islands owe you a great debt.
I'm the master of life.
Oh, I think that's a good place.
So we can fix the machine. Come on, people.
Shush, I'm doing an outro. I think that's a good place to call it here. I guess next time we're going to the egg chamber. So in this scene, this is where I'm looking at the sun basically for the first time on the Ring of Fire, and it just, you can see the gamma spiking. It's, for me, it was bringing back ideas of other games that I've played and just started thinking of all the times that designers and developers have done such a great job with lighting effects. I mean, one that comes to mind is when I was playing Rift and I saw like the sun streaming through the trees, and it just brought back, you could kind of see that with like almost like the lens flare and stuff like that. So definitely that was the gamma moment for me. I think the beta spikes are due to concentration and just, you know, taking it all in. And finally it's daylight, and look at, yeah, beautiful. These next two clips kind of just show two parts of this. You'll probably see it throughout the whole thing, of probably what all of our brains are going through when we are traversing this area, and it was us trying to figure out how to get around. So you can definitely see in this first clip, me looking at the map and trying to figure out how to get around, and you kind of see the spike in gamma. So that's just basically forming ideas once again. And then in the next clip, just me more figuring out how to get around and whatnot. So, enjoy.
Let's see what the thermal tube has in store for us.
In this next clip, you see me speculating on, basically, I think I called it Marioing through lava tubes. And the whole while I'm doing that, you can see the gamma spiking. This is basically me forming the idea of, like, I wonder if I can do this, if it is possible, all that stuff. And then at the end, you see me land, which leads into a beta spike, which is now setting me for being alert and ready to fight, just like a Norn. Please tell me you can Mario Kart that, or... Oh, you can. Here, I'm sure not many YouTubers or streamers would like to point this out, but I think it's important for brainwave-wise. Here you can kind of see me turn for a yawn. Like I said, I was doing this kind of late at night once I got my computer up and running. And at that moment, you can kind of see the theta waves spike, which theta waves are usually linked to drowsiness and whatnot. So that is probably why. So enjoy. Enjoy me fighting napping. Ooh. Here you can catch me reading one of the Mursaat tablets, and that little bit of lore that we kind of never heard before, it starts making the gamma waves peak, so basically another forming of ideas. And also you can see the beta ones peaking as well, so that probably is due to me concentrating on the tablets. And also, once I realize, ooh, time for lore, that's usually what makes me wide awake. So, there you go. Races reemerge. Oh no, lore! The once powerful Jotun refused to rely on magic ever again. Since remained ignorant, brutish creatures. Oh. I definitely wanted to show this off because I think it's something we can all relate to as Guild Wars 2 players. Basically, I wanted to call it like the mind of the Rezzer or the mind of the Savior. Basically, you can kind of see someone bounce into the screen, and then all of a sudden, as their opponent comes in, as I'm fighting my own, I start to try to, you know, have a goal of rezzing this person back up and saving them so they don't have to make a long trek back. So you can kind of see the definitely spikes in gamma where I'm trying to figure out a good way to fight these guys because they are a bit tough. And then definitely spikes in beta for alertness. And I would say alpha because you've probably seen the alpha because I am playing a game. I'm still being relaxed and whatnot. But I think it was definitely cool to show off to the Guild Wars 2 community. I'd like to help you, but you really made it difficult.
I need energy.
Here you can see my first interaction with an ether seal, the towers that are very reminiscent of Guild Wars 1. Basically, when it starts shooting that beam, you can see the gamma spike, and basically I've decided to try to run past it, and I am basically thinking of how I'm going to get all these conditions off of me easily. Oh no. Now this one is actually showing a losing battle, which I thought was definitely important to show brainwave-wise. As I jump into the fight with the Jades, and all of a sudden I basically get knocked around and can't do anything, you can see the gamma and beta spiking, where basically I'm trying to figure out what went wrong, and basically I'm attentive to see if I could notice any way to get past these three jade constructs. So enjoy. A lot of things there. No, no, no. No! Much like some of the other lore speculating parts, this is just my brain working as I try to see the banner and, you know, something heavy was dragged off me, speculating on, was it a dwarf? Was it, you know, maybe one of the jade constructs that in a fight with one of the dwarves? Because I definitely think one of those banners belongs to the dwarves. But yeah, here's my brain spiking on gamma for some lore. Guessing that could be very dwarven. And last but not least, we have the cinematic of the egg chamber going on. And here you can definitely see a lot of gamma that's basically my mind racing with possibilities, along with, you know, spikes in beta and alpha, which the beta is probably more than likely me concentrating on the video. Whereas the alpha, since I'm out of combat and all that stuff, it's probably me being awake, but more relaxed in the process. Well, those are the moments I found in the part that were excellent to note. But if you found other ones, do leave them in the comments, and definitely would love to talk to you guys about it. I also want to ask everyone, do you prefer this all in one chunk, or would you want to see these separated so it's like kind of just the Let's Play version and then an analysis? Would that be more appealing to people? While I did say these were coming out probably Tuesdays, when it becomes in regular rotation, it'll probably be Wednesday to make it a little easier when all this stuff drops on Tuesdays. So look for these on Wednesdays in general. And make sure to hit subscribe, like, and follow me on Twitter. And see everyone next time. Bye.